There were a lot of cool laptops at CES 2019, but there was one that came as a bit of a surprise, and that was the new Alienware Area 51M. What's really interesting about this laptop is that, unlike all of its peers, it wasn't trying to be super thin and light. Instead, this laptop is all about performance. So let's take a look at what that means in real-world gaming. The first thing you're going to notice about the new Area 51M is the design. It represents a new design direction for Alienware and a new design direction for the industry as a whole. This system looks very modern and sleek, but it also has some really cool sci-fi elements, like the font on the back of the laptop that says A51, and there's this really awesome Tron-like loop of light on the back of it as well. It's a really sleek presentation that is a lot different from other laptops out there, which tend to be a lot of hard edges, a lot of black and red surfaces, although you can get this laptop in black if you so choose. Now, despite all the new and modern design language here, this is in many ways a very old school laptop, and that includes the size of the laptop. This is 8.5 pounds, okay? And it's also 1.6 inches thick, thereabouts. So you are looking at a pretty sizable laptop. Again, that is different from a lot of the competition, okay? All of the other competitors are going very thin and light. So you're looking at systems that are like 0.7 inches thick and they weigh like 4.5 pounds. So those are oftentimes about half the size, at least in thickness, as this laptop is. But the Area 51M is promising it will pay that back in performance. Now, due to the size of this laptop, you have a lot of space for a keyboard, and it's a pretty nice keyboard. It's a unit that has lots of big keys and a numpad, plus you have macro keys over on the left side, so you can choose some extra, like make your own little custom key arrangements there for specific games. Overall, great keyboard. You can tap on it really quickly. Now, I have fewer good things to say about the touchpad. I mean, it works, it functions, but it's pretty small. It's not a very big surface. In fact, a lot of 13-inch laptops have bigger touchpads, and it doesn't feel that responsive in multi-touch gestures. Again, it totally works, but I think the expectation here is that you'll really be using this with a mouse that you plug in, so the touchpad hasn't been given as much focus. Now, there's plenty of room for connectivity here, and you get all kinds of connectivity. The main things to highlight are that you have very good video outputs, HDMI 2.0, mini DisplayPort, 1.4, plus you've got your Thunderbolt 3, which also acts as USB Type-C. So you're really covered. No matter what you want to connect this laptop to, any sort of external monitor, you're going to be set right here. And then there's a lot of other little doohickeys and add-ons on this system. You know, this is a flagship system, so you have things like Tobii eye tracking. You can actually use that software to control your desktop with a glance of your eyes, or do the same in games. It only works in a limited number of scenarios, but it is a neat little trick and something that's fun to try out. You also get per key RGB LED backlighting on the keyboard, and you can fully customize that through the Alienware Command Center. So you can change it to flash or not flash to show any color that you like right there in the software. Oh, and one little extra that is definitely a bit unusual, but it has a 2.5 gigabits per second Ethernet port, which, you know, that's a little crazy. You probably don't need it, but hey, if you have some sort of outlandishly fast internet connection wherever you live, good on you. This laptop will do it. Now, the new design was kind of half of Dell's pitch with this laptop. The other half was the upgradability, because this system, it uses desktop grade components, and because it's so large, you can actually get in there, you can switch out a lot of things. You can switch out pretty much all the major components: RAM, hard drive, CPU, and yes, even the GPU, which is not to say that there's a video card hidden in here. No, nothing like that. But there is a module in there that Dell says they're going to sell upgrades for in the future. We don't know how much those upgrades are going to cost, or exactly, you know, what they're going to be on the upgrades. At this point, this system comes with the best GPUs you can buy anyway. There's nothing to upgrade to yet. But in the future, those should be coming down the pipe. However, there's a little bit of a problem here, because this system actually is not so easy to upgrade. You might think, considering all that's been said about the upgrades, that you could just get right in there, pop things out, not a big deal. But actually, you have to dig around the system a fair bit in order to do that. You have to remove a lot of different components from the system in order to get access to that GPU and CPU. It's doable, but it's definitely a pain, and I think a lot of people are not going to be comfortable doing it. Also, the system doesn't really feel like it's set up to be messed with too often. These plastics are pretty soft on this system. They look great, but once you start going at it with pliers and screwdrivers and whatnot, there's a pretty high risk you're going to scratch something. So it doesn't really feel like something that's actually built with the intention that you're gonna frequently open it. Heck, there's not even an easy way to open it from the bottom. When you get all the screws out, you have to pry it open a little bit. It's not like there's a latch or a divot you can just sort of put your hand in there and open it up. And I found that kind of surprising, considering this is supposed to be a system where upgradability is a focus. Now, as mentioned, the Alienware Area 51M comes with desktop-grade components, and that means great things for performance. If you get the $2,000 model, which is the entry level, you're going to get a Core i7-8700 processor with a RTX 2060 graphics chip, and our upgraded review unit with all the tricks had a Core i9-9900K processor with an NVIDIA RTX 2080 graphics chip. That is really impressive hardware. Now, if you compare that to a standard mobile Core i7 and most of the gaming laptops out there, you're gonna see this tricked out model gets about 40% better multi-core performance and about 20% better single core performance. That's a huge leap forward. You're definitely going to notice that no matter what you're doing, really. Now, this system also comes with a full fat RTX 2080 graphics chip, not the Max-Q version, which is what you find in most gaming laptops. That one has to sort of downclock itself here and there in order to meet the thermal restraints of those systems. Not here. And that does have a consequence when it comes to performance. You're going to get 116 frames per second average in Battlefield 5 at 1080p in ultra detail. That's going to be about 10 or 20 frames per second more on average than any of the other gaming laptops out there. Also, Assassin's Creed Odyssey. That is one of the most demanding games you can possibly throw at a gaming PC right now. And you're going to be able to play that at 1080p ultra detail, 73 frames per second average. Any of the other gaming laptops out there, you're going to be looking at 50 to 60 frames per second average with an RTX 2080 Max-Q. So that's a pretty big leap up in performance, and it's definitely something you're going to notice while you're gaming. Now, a downside to all of this performance is battery life. You're only going to get about an hour and a half to 3 hours of battery life, depending on what you're doing. Also, you have two power adapters with this system, two of them. The ones that you get depend on the performance of the Alienware Area 51M that you purchase. So if you get the base model, you're gonna get two 180 watt power adapters. Ours came with a 330 watt plus a 180 watt power adapter. Now, despite all the power on tap here, you're only going to get a selection of 1080p displays to choose from. There's no 4K, no 1440p option. And that is a little bit strange, I think, considering the performance here. It actually would support a 1440p display nicely. It could even do a lot of games in 4K. We tested this system with 1440p and 4K external monitors, and in most games, you're gonna be able to run at 4K resolution in high to ultra detail and get 60 frames per second. A lot of older games, you can actually hit a lot higher than that. So it's kind of strange that there isn't a better display option available. But with that said, the 1080p display that is here is really nice. It looks great, it's bright, it's vivid, it is very smooth when you're taking advantage of the higher refresh rate options. So it's not awful or anything like that, and 1080p can be a really good match for a lot of games. I just wish there was 4K available. Now again, that base model Area 51M with the Core i7-8700 and the RTX 2060 graphics, that's gonna set you back about $2,000. That's not a terrible price to pay for a gaming laptop by any means, but you are not going to get quite the same level of performance as we quote in this review. That's substantially less powerful hardware. If you want the top shelf model that we tested with the Core i9 and the RTX 2080 graphics, that's going to set you back $4,500. The Area 51M in its most expensive, most powerful configuration is a lot more than your typical mobile laptop. You get something like a Razer Blade or an Acer Predator Triton 500 with an RTX 2080 Max-Q graphics chip in it, and you're gonna be looking at around $3,000. The Area 51M is going to beat those systems in every benchmark. Sometimes it's gonna beat them by a lot, but it's also a lot more expensive. So you have to really think about whether or not that's worth it to you. And also, whether or not you can live with those huge power adapters. That said, if maximum performance in the laptop is your absolute primary concern, you really need to give the Area 51M a look. We already talked a lot about the Alienware Area 51M, but there's also still a lot more to know about this laptop. So if you want to hear more, go to digitaltrends.com and check out the full review. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you like what you saw.